common sense is neither common nor sensical. Critically discuss. I am reading the question, common sense of the question asked. I have in the syllabus the word called common sense in sociology, common sense in sociology in the first unit. From that syllabus word topic, I am going to the class lecture and the textbooks, and I am pulling points from there. This is the process which every one of you will have to follow. So what is the answer which you can give to this question? How you will start the answer? Starting should be impressive. Ending should be very impressive. Because in the conclusion only they are going to give you the score. What should be the introduction? Common sense is not common, neither common nor sensical. Common sense was regarded as a fallacy foisted by culture according to positivism. August Comte argued that divorcing common sense from sociological theories will make sociology as an independent discipline with a scientific status. Critics to common sense argue that common sense is not shared commonly by all people in the society because of individual discrepancies, individual idiosyncrasies. If common sense is commonly shared by all, then every actor present will be a robo programmed by the society. People will not engage in an activity which is not good for them. People won't gamble. So common sense on one hand is not shared by all because of individual differences. At the same time, common sense is not sensical for the simple reason it is not rational. Common sense refers to a sound judgment based on individual experience decided by the culture. The society tells you that birds of same feather flock together, but science tells you that opposite poles attract each other. Both are diametrically opposite conclusions. So the status of common sense in the sociological imagination was central to the debate since the emergence of sociology as a scientific study of society. Now next paragraph you write, how positivism criticized common sense. Renaissance scholars sowed the seeds of rationality and scientific temper, wanted to use reason and logic to reconstruct the society based on invariant laws of natural science. August Comte positioned sociology as a scientific study of society. He wanted sociology as the mother of all social sciences. He even was given the term social physics for sociology before. Like physics can predict reality objectively based on empirical knowledge, sociology should build its sociological theories derived from theories using the logic of science. So he wanted common sense to be rejected for making sociology as a positive science. Following the footsteps of August Comte, Emile Durkheim also wanted sociology to become a scientific study of society. He went to the extent of even deriving a law of suicide on the lines of law of natural science. For positivists, sociological conclusions, if derived from commonsensical knowledge, will drive the society towards backwardness and irrationality, will result in social continuity rather than social dynamics. However, non-positivism rejected the scientific status of sociology. It wanted sociology to be based on individual experience, which is decided by the culture, which varies across time and space. They, especially phenomenologists, were looking at how common sense presents the raw material for the construction of hypotheses. Hypothesis is the starting point of your theory, but sourcing its inputs from sensory knowledge, which is personal in nature. Robert Madge says, people derive truth not only from the culture of the society, but also from the individual experience which they are exposed to. So truth is not just a product of science. Theories are not basically the outcomes of science. Theories can draw its raw material from common sense, is what is the idea postulated by non-positivists. Sociologists in the contemporary social world conclude offering common sense an important position in the construction of sociological theories. They don't discard common sense. They argue that man is a product of law as well as customs. Human action is decided by both rationality and emotional. So man is not only looking at the world through his scientific rationality, but also he is using his personal experiences of the past. He is having a conception about future. He is involving in what C.W. Mills calls sociological imagination. So today, sociologists are more interested to study how much is proportion of common sense and how much proportion of science is used by sociologists in the construction of social realities and sociological theories. Right? So this may be your answer. Right? So you are using the keyword, you are bringing two main theoretical points. One is positivism and non-positivism, and you are giving a balance by telling that it is a not exclusive. Common sense and science are not exclusives of each other, rather they are inclusive of each other. You cannot draw sociological inference divorcing one from the other.